Hi friends, welcome back to the class of physics for class 10. This is Ramesh. Last class we discussed about Ohm's law in detail. Okay, the Ohm's law which relates the potential difference and current and the constant values resistance. We know very well about that. Okay, in this class we are going to study about the resistance. Explanation about resistance, we do one activity. What is the activity here? Consider a circuit which is consist of a battery which consists of four 1.5 volt cells which are connected in series. That consists of a battery. So a battery is connected here. This is a key and this is ammeter. The use of ammeter is to measure the amount of current flowing through the circuit. Okay. Now there is a leave a gap between two terminals here. What is the reason for leaving gap? Because we are going to connect three components. First one is a nichrome wire. It is a nichrome wire. What wire is this? This is a nichrome wire. The second one is 10 watt electrical bulb. And third one is torch bulb. First, we are connecting the nichrome wire in the points X and Y and close the key. Now the key is open. Okay, this is open circuit. When we are connecting the nichrome wire between the points X and Y and we close the key, what happens? The current flows through the electrical circuit. Measure the amount of current flowing through the electrical circuit with the help of ammeter. Note the readings. That is the first activity. That is the first step of the activity. Then we can remove this nichrome wire. First we connect this, measure the reading of the ammeter, then we can remove this nichrome wire and then we connect this 10 watt electric bulb. This is what 10 watt electric bulb. Okay, now the key is closed, so the current flows through the circuit. Okay, is the ammeter reading changes or the ammeter shows exactly the same reading in the previous case? No, the ammeter reading changes. That means different current is passing through the circuit now when compared to the previous case. Okay, this is the second observation. The third is, now we can remove the 10 watt bulb and we can connect the torch light. For example, this is about torch light. For example, when we connect the torch light and switch on, the torch light will glow. Okay, because of the current flowing through the circuit, is the current is same or different? The current is different. There are three components we interchanged. First one, first one is nichrome wire, second one is 10 watt bulb, third one is torch bulb. But these three components consumes not the equal amount of current, which consumes different amount of current. What is the factor which varies the amount of current flowing in the circuit? There is one factor. What is that means? Resistance. In nichrome wire, it is an alloy. It has high resistance. But in 10 watt bulb, there is a low resistance. In torch bulb, there is a low resistance. So different amount of current will pass through in each case depending upon the component resistance. Here resistance is the factor which varies the amount of current flowing through the circuit. Okay, what is resistor? A resistor is a component which provides resistance. Usually, if you want to decrease the amount of current flowing through the circuit, we can connect a resistor in the circuit. Okay, resistor is a component which provides resistance, which opposes the flow of charges, so the current will decrease. Okay. If a material having very low resistance, then it is called a conductor. If a material having if a substance having very high resistance, that is called poor conductor, or it may called as insulator. In insulator the resistance is very high, in conductor the resistance is very low. Okay, what are the factors that resistance can depend upon? If we are increasing or decreasing the current, the current passing through the circuit depends upon the component's resistance. Okay, depending upon the component's resistance, the amount of current passing through the circuit varies. Okay, we learn about that. Okay, good. What are the factors that resistance of a conductor depends upon? What are the factors? We learn with another one activity. Okay, okay. Now let us consider a circuit. Which consists of one cell and a key and ammeter. The use of ammeter we know, and leave a gap. Okay. Now we will do the activity. First we are taking a nichrome wire of length L. This is the nichrome wire of length L. First this nichrome wire is connected in between the points X and Y. In between the points X and Y, the nichrome wire of length L is connected. Okay. Now we note the ammeter reading. The ammeter shows some amount of reading. Okay. We note it. Then we can replace. We can replace this nichrome wire of length L by the same material, nichrome wire of length 2L. That means twice of the length than the previous case. Here length is doubled, but the area of cross section remains same and the material remains same, which is nichrome. Here only the length is doubled. Now the ammeter reading is decreased. What magic is this? Same material, same area of cross section, but the length is doubled. The ammeter reading is now decreased. What happens? Let us wait. In the third case, the same nichrome wire, now the length and the material are same. What is the length here? L. What is the length here? L. Okay. Both length are same. What is the material? Nichrome wire. Here also nichrome wire. Compare this with first case. Both are nichrome wire, both length is L. But the area of cross section is increased here. Here the area of cross section is increased. Now the ammeter shows there is an increase in reading when compared with the previous case. Not previous case, first case. Here also we are using nichrome wire. Here also we are using nichrome wire. Length is same, but the area of cross section is increased. While we are increasing the area of cross section, there is an increase in current in the electrical circuit. That's why the ammeter shows higher reading when compared to the first case. Okay, please note it. Okay, then next, the last case. Now we are using the same length L and the same area of cross section. For example, A. Here also area of cross section A. Here also area of cross section A. Both are area of cross section A, and both length is L. But the nature of the material, here the material is copper wire, not a nichrome wire. We are changing the material of the wire, but the length and area of cross section remains the same. What happens now? The ammeter shows some different reading. Something different reading in compared to the first case. In the first case, the ammeter shows one reading. But in the fourth case, the ammeter shows some different reading. But the length and area of cross section are same, but the nature of the material is different. Why? What happens here? Okay. First, we will study the property of resistance. What are the factors which are influencing the resistance here? When we are doubling the length, the current will decrease. That means what? When we are doubling the length, the length is doubled, the length is increased, then the resistance of the wire is increased. So the amount of current passing through the circuit will be decreased. So in the first case, we learn about resistance is directly proportional to length. Yes, this is the thing first we study. We observe. the length is directly proportional to resistance. Here the length is increased, so the resistance is increased. So the amount of current passing through the circuit is decreased because resistance and current are inversely proportional. So this is first. Second one. In the second case, area of cross section increases. The current, the area of cross section increases, so the resistance will decrease. While the resistance decreases, the current passing through the circuit increases, so the ammeter shows higher reading than the first case. So here the resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. Yes. So combine these two equations, we get R is directly proportional to L and inversely proportional to A. What it means? The resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area of cross section. If we are increasing the length, by keeping the area of cross section constant, the resistance will increase. If we are increasing the area of cross section by keeping the length constant, these two are inversely proportional, so the resistance will decrease and the amount of current passing through the circuit will area of cross section increase, resistance decrease, so the amount of current passing through the circuit will increase. Okay, this is directly proportional sign. When it changes to equal sign, we put a constant, we introduce a constant, that is rho. So R is equal to rho L by A. Well, rho is what? Rho is an important constant, its name. It is RHO, rho, it is a Greek alphabet, which is nothing but it is the resistivity of a material. Where rho is the resistivity of a material. This resistivity becomes constant for a particular material. The resistivity of copper is different from the resistivity of nichrome, because nichrome is an alloy. It is made up of two metals, nickel and chromium, mixed combination of two metals, that is alloy. So the resistivity of alloys, the resistivity of nichrome is different from copper. So when we are removing and connecting copper wire of same length and same area of cross section, but the ammeter shows different reading because the resistivity is different for different metals. The resistivity of, for example, the resistivity of gold is different from copper. The resistivity of copper is different from nichrome. So for a particular metal, the resistivity is constant. It is not same for all the metals. It is an important point. So please take note of it. The resistivity is constant for particular metal. Okay. Not only metal, the resistivity is constant for a particular substance. For insulators, the resistivity value is very high. The resistivity value of insulator is very high. For example, I can write here. Okay, this is over. I write here. For insulators and conductors and alloys, for insulators resistivity value is very high. It is 10^8 something, 10^17 approximately. The unit of resistivity is ohm meter. The unit of resistance is ohm. The unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Where the unit comes? Rho is equal to what? Rho is equal to Ra by L. What is the unit of R? Resistance, ohm. Area of cross section, meter square. Length, meter. We cut it. So the unit is ohm meter. The unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Okay, good. So the conductors, the resistivity is low. For example, it is approximately 10^8 to 10^-6 ohm meter. For alloys, the resistivity is just higher. In between than conductors and insulators, it is greater than conductors. For alloys, the resistivity is greater than conductors. Okay, when a metal is isolated, that means for example, nickel is a metal. Okay, its resistivity is very low. Not very low, it's low. Okay, low. It's a good conductor. Okay, it is a metal, so it conducts electricity. Its resistivity is low. when it is turned into another metal, when it is turned into alloy, that means mixing of another metal, that means chromium, nickel plus chromium gives nichrome. Nichrome is an alloy. When it becomes alloyed, when it is mixed with another metal, nickel is mixed with another metal, chromium, then it becomes alloy, that is nichrome. When the metal turns into alloy, its resistivity increases, its behavior changes, its resistivity increases. While the resistivity increases, the resistance also increases. Okay. For this purpose, we are using alloys. For this purpose, we are using alloys in electric water heater, electric toaster, electric iron, etc. Because it produces high amount of heating effect according to Joule's law. It produces very high amount of heat because the resistivity is high when compared to conductors. Okay, this is about resistance and resistivity. So the resistance is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area, which is equal to rho L by A, where rho is the resistivity. The resistivity of conductors is low, insulators is very high. Alloys is, the resistivity of alloys is just greater than the conductor. So these alloys are purposely using for heating devices. Okay, this is about resistance and resistivity. The unit of resistance is ohm, the unit of resistivity is ohm meter. So in this class, I hope all of you very well understand about resistance and resistivity and what are the factors which affects resistance. Okay, in the next class, we are going to discuss about another one new topic. Till that, bye my friends. Bye, thank you for watching. Bye.